Hi, I'm Vicky Beeching, and today I'll be joined by David Crowder, who'll be sharing his song Never Let Go. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this new song cafe at worshiptogether.com. I've recently been listening to one of your songs in one of my quiet time iPod mixes, because I think worship songs that deal with hard times are kind of few and far between. Mm-hmm. And this is one of my very favorites.
Oh, that's amazing.
So that's... tell me a bit about how Never Let Go came into being.
It was another co-write situation with our band. Our violin player came rushing into the barn during the recording process and said, I have a chorus, I think. And it actually was this, he's got a pretty significant punk background, and it was a real lively punk rock tune. But he promised, he said he was sitting around the house, and as soon as he started playing it, his cat flipped out and started running around, and he thought, I think I might be on something. So he rushed over immediately. And it actually, as we started talking about things and sitting around the barn, the song, you know, it's rare that you're a part of a song that sort of writes itself. And this was, lots of times it feels like a, you know, struggle and you're trying to piece things together. And this one, in a matter of, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, the thing was just there. And it was most of the band was around at the time, and it was just a real collaborative, everybody speaking in. A lot of it was, we went through a pretty significant moment as a church. Our pastor died in a very public way. He was baptizing a friend of ours and was electrocuted and killed, and it was just something that you wouldn't expect a community to, it's just a bizarre occurrence. And so we had been through a lot as a community, and these songs that sort of found their way onto this record that we were making were the other side of this sort of hope all in one place, and hope in a put together in a manner that allowed us to express it as a real felt thing rather than such a fluffy word that it tends to be within our faith, you know, but something that was necessary and really present and felt. And this song became something of a pivotal thing for us, and it sort of plays with English a little bit in the sense that it uses the same words to be past and present, or be present tense and past tense. The chorus is just never let go, and it, in the first sense it's a present tense experience, and then later it's a past tense experience, and that sort of was our way of God's always constant and his presence. There's not a thing that's happened within human history that he's not been present in, and that's a hard thing to put in your head, because there's a lot of stuff that's really been pretty horrific to go on within human history, and to think God was active and present in those moments is just difficult, but yet it's no less true. And so anyway, this song is just sort of saying some simple things that are really not so simple in my mind. That's pretty much it. Never let go.
Yeah, it's good to turn pain into like a trust and give people something to sing to voice how they're feeling.
Yeah, I think that's been a healthy thing within the recent past of the church. It seems like there are more songs that allow us as a community of believers to express all that life has to bring us. You know, there's a lot of joy within life, but there's also a lot of pain, and I think we as the church need to have expressions of both. We look at the Psalms, and there's definitely questions and dire moments that are expressed and articulated, and it seems like we as writers should be doing the same thing. So yeah,
we'd love to hear it.
Okay, this would be Never Let Go. Clouds brought rain, and disaster came. Oh my soul, when waters rose and hope had flown. Oh my soul, oh my soul. Ever faithful, ever true, you I know, you never let go. Oh, you never let go, you never let go, you never let go. You never let go, you never let go, you never let go.
home.
Sure. So that says really, like I said, it's a very simple song, and it says, I think, pretty simple things. I think it's necessary to have that ability to say stuff back to God, in the sense that, wow, there's been a lot of dark stuff happen, but you've been present and you pulled us through, and that means, I think, in turn, you will again.
Yeah, that's true.
Because there will be other horrific things headed our way, I'm certain. Mm, you know?
That's true.
And also, we've used it in our set as a band. It's been really helpful to have just a moment where things are sort of stripped away and you have this real intimacy that's sort of a breath in the middle of a set that's fairly high energy for the most part. And so it's been a really beautiful thing to watch unfold in a live sense as well.
That's cool. Is it normally just you on piano for
that? No, it begins there, and of course, you know, everybody eventually has a voice in it, and it sort of has this little build moment towards the end. The bridge gets pretty
intense. Yeah, like on the record.
Intense. Yeah, very similar. Yes.
Wow, and if someone was going to try and replicate that beautiful piano playing?
Yeah, it's pretty difficult, isn't it? basically, all you need to know is the E and the A. We're in E, and so it's just your one and your four. And it does do the walk down with the six to the four, back to the one, to your... So that's pretty much all you've got. I guess the bridge goes to the 5, 4, 1. But yeah, the actual parts are pretty simple.
And on guitar, that'd be pretty simple too.
In fact, when we do on guitar, I usually capo way up and play in a G form, and it seems to work really well.
Kind of mandolin-esque.
Yeah, very true, very true. And also in a live setting, if you've happened to see us, what I do is I have a Boss DD6 delay pedal on it, so it kind of has a more floaty, you know, put a couple of repeats on it, has a little...
So then every time you hit it, it would be like...
Yeah, exactly.
That's very cool.
Oh, yeah.
So the master of tricks you are, sir.
Oh, yes. Very wizard-like, I tell you. It's just genius. My gosh, how do we think of these
things?
Thank
you for sharing your wizardry with us.
You're very welcome.
Mr. Crowder.
Good to be with you.